Here's a collection of some of the work I've done over the past few months. And it's quite varied. And the reason it's so varied is because I've never picked up a paintbrush in my life before. I've only been painting for 12, maybe 15 months now. And so to have this stick with hairs on the end, which are a bit wet, in this coloured pulp, and then touch it on this tissue paper, which sucks it in and blobs before you can even flick a cat's whisker. I mean, it's just it's incredibly difficult, especially as I'm in my 40s and I haven't got a blind clue about Western art whatsoever, because I've never done it. The thing that caught me about Chinese painting is I used to do double bar black gothic calligraphy, and then I started getting into all the usual sort of Western calligraphic styles. Well, it gets a bit boring after a while. You've got 26 shapes to master, and when you've mastered your 26 shapes, it kind of bores your socks off after a while. It just loses its fire. So I thought, well, I want to take up Chinese calligraphy, and so the years have ticked by. I mean, this is 1986 when I was doing the traditional German style Gothic calligraphy and such like. And it was just a year ago I decided, year and a half ago, I decided to have a go at Chinese calligraphy. And actually what started to grow on me was the fact that with Chinese, the characters and the pictures, the Chinese don't differentiate really between the two, because they're both pictures in the very raw literal sense. And so that's why you see them both together, because they work together. Then I started looking at the old masters, just like I did when I was into commercial industrial photography. Start looking at the old masters, see how they did it, see the materials they use. I love that element. I bought very old cameras and used my own handmade paper sometimes, but very old sepia paper, bromide papers, not the modern chlorobromide papers, because I just love to work like the masters did. And there's nothing different with the Chinese calligraphy here at all. It's exactly the same. I like to use old paper, and I need to use the best paper. Red Star Schuon paper. I want to know what that's like, so I can compare it with the cheaper papers. I want to use handmade brushes, scruffy, crappy, shitty little cheap brushes which are worth nothing, and then some brushes I've got are worth £60 and £70. Really, in my hands, there's not very much difference between using the two in my hands. But that being said, I want to taste it all. But that being said, I pointed out to a brush manufacturer or a brush supplier online one of the masters painting a peony. And he had this brush which sagged, didn't return to its normal shape. It broke at the end when he bent it, and it left these lovely lines on the peony which joined the petals to the body of the flower and so on. Beautiful. The response I got from the brush manufacturer was that this brush was actually a crappy cheap thing. It didn't return to its shape, it didn't keep its point, and one they had did. That might be good if you were doing calligraphy. This guy was painting a peony. And if that was just a crappy, shitty little cheap brush, the peony was absolutely gobsmacking. It's beautiful, and this is a master, so I learned very quickly that it doesn't matter what brush you put into the hand of a master, he'll make a beautiful painting out of it because he knows how it works. Therefore, on these lines, I saw that there is actually no such thing as a good or a bad brush. It's all down to how you use it. It's tools for the job. So you've got one kind of brush and you've got one kind of paper, and you can make that kind of picture with that combination. So my education has been bitty. There's some wonderful people over in America, and Chinese, and Americans, and just a whole mix, hodgepodge of people who've assisted me along the way with inkstones and inksticks and brushes and paper, and just helping me buy them online because of a language problem or because of a nationality problem or whatever it is. and I've been able to learn a little bit, enough to make little critters and bugs like this, and birds and flowers and shapes and whatever, and learn how the paper works. And really, I mean, if I started painting at 5 years old, I'm only 6 and a half now. It's been difficult. On top of this, I'm trying to build a life. So it's very time consuming, but it's very addictive, and I can see why people get so excited about it. And so I don't really know what the word is. It just the whole style of, to me, spontaneous Chinese painting. It's beautiful. It's not like the Western paintings that I see where people are trying to be a camera. I can't, that just doesn't appeal to me. That's why I picked up a camera in the first place. Chinese art is wonderful because it's just this sort of stylized, but nevertheless, a splash of color on paper. And there's a way that that paint has to hit that paper with the brush that gives it that wonderful Chinese essence. And that really is what attracts me. Some of the things I try are absolutely appalling, but I post them anyway. Some of the pictures I'm quite pleased with, some I think absolutely downright embarrassing, but I post them anyway. The reason I post them is because I'm trying to stoke up the confidence of people who otherwise wouldn't post their work online. But after seeing mine, and having a laugh, they think, ah, I can do better than this, and they might come forwards. But actually, I think only one person has in the whole of Europe. Two, in fact. But one of those is a poet. Our dash poet. So, I don't know whether I've inspired him to pick up a paintbrush, but I haven't seen any of his Chinese paintings yet. But he might do some verse in Chinese, who knows? At least with a Chinese accent. So anyway, this is some work that I've done, and some videos of the painting exhibition I'm still desperately trying to work on. Currently there are one or two hurdles, shall we say, which hinder that progress. Changing over to new servers being one of them. But it's ongoing, and it will happen, and it will come about. Thank you to all the people who've sort of called by and had a look in, and had a laugh with me, and given me valuable advice. The majority of my paintings I rather like, purely because I remember the fun that I experienced painting all these different things. And so that's really how I work. It's all purely down to that spiritual essence, that sensation of watching this thing appear in front of you on the paper. Whether it looks like what it's supposed to look like, I don't know. But it's the whole enthusiastic sort of process, the actual creative process, that is what really fires me up. And seeing these fun little critters on the paper afterwards. Anyway, hope you like what you see. And I just thought I'd put this together this evening because I was flicking through and I thought, crikey, that really is quite diverse. So, the birds, a lot of my birds look angry. Got little angry frowns on them, but that's just the way they're painted. They're probably not angry really in real life. So, good night for now, and thanks for calling in. Bye-bye.